today we're going to test a new event, the Battle of the Narrow Sea. It's a really enjoyable event. They got some new content. We're going to sail across the Narrow Sea and salvage ships, find treasures, fight enemies, and help Daenerys and Daeron to conquer the Narrow Sea. Okay, so we're going to get on the map. As you can see, we've got the rules button, modify warship. We'll talk about that later. A stage quest, the battle map, and ranking. And here we've got the today's quest, and as you can see, to move around, you use voyage supplies. You start with 1,000, and they ask for 10 to move to one spot. And the phase objective is to occupy the Lorath Lighthouse. Okay, so let's see where that is. We've got this lighthouse. Just going to move this here. And it seems like there will be more. We've got the one we're doing now, the Black Squid and Tarth Lighthouse. Three more. We need to finish this stage quest in order to be able to open the other areas, I guess. Okay, so let's see how this works. This is my ship. We start from harbor. We've got 1,000 supplies. And my advice is to not click and move, because you're spending 10 supplies per move, but just click on the shipwrecks, because it costs you 20 supplies, but at the same time you can salvage the shipwreck. What are the shipwrecks? Well, like the name says, it's a wrecked ship. Okay, that if you salvage it, gives you lots of stuff. Let's try one, so you can see what it can give you. It says here there's a chance to obtain a mysterious treasure and map fragments, but there are lots of other things that you will get. Let's take this one. Your ship we'll move there, and this is what I can get from this ship. Army bonuses, treasure map fragment, or promoting a commander to 4-star. The most important thing to mention about this is that all the buffs and everything you get from a voyage, the starting when you start exiting the harbor and until you finish all your voyage supplies, all those bonuses will only apply to that voyage. So if you're getting all your commanders to 4-stars or all your stats maxed, they won't apply in your next voyage. So that's why you have to carefully spend your supplies, because the same supplies are used to attack enemies. Let's say the lighthouse, it asks for 50, and if you want to attack a normal troop or ship, 50. So the enemies ask for 50 supplies per attack. Okay, so don't waste it. My advice is to attack first the lighthouse, for example, because it's the stage quest. See what the troops and stats he has, and then salvage shipwrecks in order to get your bonuses, because the funny thing is that you start without stats. So you have to advance and get your stats by salvaging those shipwrecks. Okay, let's try and attack an enemy ship so you can see what my stats are. Okay, we'll use scavs. Also, the troops are not your own. You get a number of fixed troops once you exit the harbor, and those are the troops that you'll use during your voyage. Okay, so these are my stats. As you can see, really, really low. And these are the stats of the enemy ship, which is a normal enemy ship, not an elite, not the lighthouse. Those are stronger. So in order to increase these bonuses, you have to salvage shipwrecks. So I know the lighthouse is Infcav, okay, because I've attacked it previously. So all my army bonuses that I'm going to select from the shipwrecks will be cavs. So we've got 930 supplies left, so we should try and make the best of it. I'll just salvage some more. We've got a fragment. I did unlock, I think, 2 or 3 treasure maps. It takes you to a point where supposedly a mysterious treasure is, and you get, for example, I got a window similar to this one. It wasn't anything really special, okay? So I said we're going to focus on calves. I don't need spear. I'm taking the map fragment. Let's take some more ships. So yeah, if you click outside this window, I didn't, but I thought I did, the window just disappears. So you have to be careful not to click outside the window, because the game considers you don't want to select any of those buffs. So just look at them carefully and select one, or if you're not really interested, you can just close it. But I think any buff is better than none. You get troops as well. They add immediately, and you can increase your number of troops. You can see your troops here. So this is what you normally get: 1 million of each T4s. And some T1 and T3 boats. More 4-star commanders. This is nice, but I'm not using any of them. I'm using cabs, so any bonus on cab is welcome. This one is really interesting as well. It converts your infantry health bonuses from the mysterious treasures, these ones, into infantry attack. So it increases your stats pretty well. This one gives you 50 supplies and another battle one. Could go with the supplies, as I'm not using imps. Thank you. So we've got 600 supplies left. Let's see how the battle works. When you go near the lighthouse or attack enemies, they'll attack you back. Okay, so that's why you need the troops as well. I should have moved closer, but now we'll just have to attack from here. So as I already told you, what I do is salvage a shipwreck or attack an enemy to move around, so it's like two bunnies in one shot. So for getting closer, I would just salvage one of these shipwrecks. So let's see how this works. Okay, not bad. This morning I was killing around 500,000 when I didn't know how to use those things. So yeah, he's Inf Cav, and it says he plays with T2s, but look at his stats. Yeah, bows and infantry, and the commander skills apply as well for the enemy. So that's why it's pretty important you get those 4-star commanders. Okay. It's going to be a long while till we can kill the enemy, the lighthouse, the guy, what is called, Lorath. But I think if more people join and you keep hitting it, just like in the Night King event, he'll eventually die. Let's take a look at the other buttons. So we've got the rules. There's not anything complicated. It's pretty well explained. You've got some talent tree, which you'll need a warship modification hammer, and I'm going to show you where to get it. This is it. You get stage rewards when you finish the stage, when the Lorath guy dies. So you get this warship modification hammer and some SS troop appearance tokens. Okay, the others are locked. This is the map and the ranking of players. Oh, I'm on 6th. That's not bad. Oh. Okay, so for the ranking reward, the new thing and the surprise this event is going to bring is an ancient weapon for Sorin, which gives you resource gathering speed. Yay! Not, but okay. So the others are just Heartseeker tests, which is the same. Okay, you get the weapon if you end up on the first place, but you get chests that will probably give you the weapon or other weapons. I'm sure there are players out there that would want to increase their gathering speed, so this weapon might help doing that. I don't know. And what other things I could show you? So this is like where everything you got this voyage, the bonuses, the army, the supplies and spoils, the commanders you brought to 4 stars. So if you are uncertain of your stats or bonuses, you can just check this button. Okay, the map, the barracks, The search is searching shipwrecks, because I'm imagining that on a bigger server, there will be lots of players salvaging shipwrecks, and these shipwrecks won't just lay around like this, where there are few players looking for them. So I think this is it. I'm going to spend the rest of my supplies so I can show you what you get after finishing the supplies and what happens. When you're getting attacked, you can't just move to another ship and they'll recall, or just move normally and the enemy recalls. They're not really strong when they attack. I'll show you the report in a second. Okay, another fragment. I don't think that's really good to avoid those attacks. You can get nice points by eliminating some enemies, but I just wanted to show you how to dodge them if you want. Okay, so I'm still getting nice hits, and this is the hit of the Ironborn ship that attacked me. As you can see, they're not really strong. They do have the stats, but they're losing lots of points. So you get those points, those elimination points. So now, we've got 10 supplies left. We can salvage a shipwreck, we can attack an enemy, so we can just return to harbor, which is this button that says return for replenishment. I can return to harbor and replenish because I've wasted all my voyages for today. You've got a limit of 6, and I did use all of mine. So, but when you go back to the harbor, you get the supplies, you get them replenished to 1000, you get your troops back, okay? And you get essences that you can use in the shop. That the icon of the shop, it's on the first page of the event. I'm going to show you now. You finish a voyage, you get this Shade of the Evening essences, depending on your points on your enemy elimination. So you can use those to buy items in this shop. We've got the Heartseeker chests, some ancient scripture, this rare crystal essence that will help you upgrade your 8 castle skins. Okay, so refined rough and those battle equipment material and weapon reforge ore. So I've got like 15,000, so they're not really hard to get, and you could buy some nice stuff. As you can see, you can only make 6 voyages per day, and I've topped mine, so I can't go back anymore. But you should keep this in mind before you go out there. So if there's a limit number of voyages you can make, you should make the best of it. I've used mine to test everything, the shipwrecks, the buffs, the stats, the enemies, formations, if the commander skill works. So I can't go back anymore to get more points. But in the public server, you should really make the best of it, and keep in mind that you only got 6 attempts per day. So I think that this was it. It's a pretty nice event. I do really enjoyed it. I don't know if there are going to be any changes in the public server. If not, this do work really well. We're testing it. We're now reporting minor glitches. I didn't see any major problems, so I guess this is going to work really nice on the public server. I can't wait to play it normally and to join the event along with my friends. So this is it. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll hear or see each other again soon. Goodbye.